We call this the thinking cloth. We jot down memos, theories, trains of thought. It's a very useful tool. I located the bones of the Fenchurch Street ghoul by sketching out the street plans here at 3 in the morning over cheese on toast.
When a case goes badly and we're not talking to each other, it's good for exchanging insults too.
Oh, how often does that happen?
Almost never.
Where's Lockwood?
Don't sound too pleased to see me. How about, oh my God, Lucy, I'm so glad you're okay. Oh, I'm so relieved you're still alive.
Oh my God, Lucy, I'm so glad you're okay. I'm so relieved you're still alive.
Don't just say exactly those words.
It's not funny, Lockwood. Ever since you hired her, things have gone downhill. What if she's unhinged?
She's not unhinged.
You're hardly the best judge of these things. You need normal people around you.
You really think you're normal, George?
Can't you even be bothered to cross the landing to wind me up?
What about Wood's ghost is here?
20 seconds. Not metaphorical.
All that and still no trousers?
Trousers are for wimps.
I mean, why can't we change the rules?
Because we're nobodies.
No, we're not. We're Lockwood and Co. You, me and George.
Glad you didn't get me fired.
Every time we're ahead, someone kicks us in the nuts, knocks us back down again. What? Why are you making that face?
What face?
That face. That's not your normal face. That's your I know something you don't face.
Promise me you won't be angry.
Why would we be angry?
You haven't. You didn't. The ring.
You lunatic! What the?
When we get up there, we need to be at our absolute best. Totally professional. So I'll do the talking.
I saw Sir John Fairfax once. He donated my school's iron defences and gave his speech in assembly and everything. Miss Kingston got her hair done special.
Yes, George. That is exactly the sort of thing I don't want you saying.
He won't show. He knows.
It was annoying, because you take the lie and you take Kipps's face and you put them together, right?
And you just want to watch him die. Sorry. Very long night. Please tell me this, Dee.
Unless Kareem has a better answer.
Yes, I do, actually.
You do?
Yeah.
You sure you do?
I know who that man is.
Bickerstaff's crest.
Thank you, Bobby. You've been a wonderful assistant. The man in this casket is Edmund Bickerstaff, a dodgy Victorian doctor with secret links to the occult and a missing mirror that will be worth a fortune to some very ruthless people.
Well, looks like the best team won, eh?
What the hell is he doing?
Whatever the hell he wants.
We've got you now. You're safe now, okay? You're with us.
That's the last time you go and do a job on your own.
I don't care what the skull says.
We're your team, not him.
Did you find anything?
Here.
You're incredible.
What I mean is that we're gonna do this. Both of us. For George.
For George. You're not done. Don't say that. This isn't how you die.
How do you know?
We won't let you, will we, George?
Never.
This is so touchy-feely.
It's a medical necessity, George. Doesn't mean a thing.
Thank you.
Have you got the glasses?
This is my secret recipe. Off to you. Coming through.
I was wrong about George. He didn't hate my guts.
Oh, and
he actually turned out to be a bit of a hero, which is good. Lockwood almost died 1,000 times, but
think he's decided he's better off alive, which is really good.